Hello, welcome to the chemistry course. Next we are moving into other topic, that is ionic product of water or ionization of water. How the water is undergoing ionization? If it is undergoing ionization, there is always equilibrium is established between dissociated ion and undissociated ion. By applying law of mass action, we can write expression in terms of constant. This constant we call it as ionic product of water. Let's see how we can express this ionic product of water. Water is dissociated very small extent into H plus ion, hydrogen ion, hydroxyl ion, and it forms ionic equilibrium. Once it is formed ionic equilibrium, we can write equilibrium expression by taking law of mass action. That is, equilibrium constant K equal to concentration of the product by concentration of the reactant. And this is very small extent ionization. When we are taking bulk water, in that there is a small extension which undergo ionization. So this case, let us assume this is a Kc, equilibrium constant, and this water is present very high concentration. Let us assume this is a constant here. So Kc equal concentration of H plus or concentration of OH minus, and here water is present higher concentration. Let us assume it is a constant, because in the bulk a very small amount it is undergoing ionization. If I take here Kc dot K equal to concentration of H plus and concentration of OH minus, Kc is constant, K is constant, and the product of two constant also constant. That constant we call it as ionic product of water, and it is a water ionization. We are writing subscript W equal to H plus concentration OH minus, and this KW is called as ionic product of water or dissociation constant of water. So ionic product of water. So here KW is ionic product of water. So they experimentally found that the pure water, the value of KW is pure water at 25 degrees centigrade. The KW value is equal to 10 power minus 14 mole square by liter square. In pure water, the concentration of hydrogen ion H plus and hydroxyl ion must be equal. So I can write KW equal H plus. If assume OH minus, I can substitute here, total become H plus whole square. I can write the concentration of H plus equal to under root of KW, or concentration of OH minus equal to under root of KW. If I substitute here, for pure water concentration at 25 degrees, what is the KW? 10 power minus 14 mole square by liter square. Then if I remove root, 10 power minus 7 mole per liter. So this is the concentration of H plus ion at 25 degrees in pure water. Similarly, in the pure water, H plus concentration and OH minus concentration must be equal. So another 10 power minus 14 we can assign to OH minus ion concentration. So all together it is equal to Kw value. And the Kw value is depends on temperature. Temperature changes, Kw value changes. Whatever the data I have mentioned, it is at 25 degrees. For example, if I added strong acid to water, what happens to Kw? Kw value remains same. It is depends on only temperature. Let's take Kw equal to concentration of H plus and concentration of OH minus, that is equal to 10 power minus 14 at 25 degrees. If I added a strong acid, what happened when we are adding strong acid? H plus concentration is increasing. We are adding H plus acid. Now H plus concentration is increasing. When we are adding a acid, the concentration of OH minus decreases to produce a constant value, because we have product of A and B. A is increasing, B must be decreases to get a constant value. Similarly, if you are adding a base OH minus, OH minus concentration is increasing, H plus concentration decreases, we get a constant value. Whether we are adding acids and bases, Kw value will not change, it remain constant at particular temperature. In summary, I am giving here. So the water undergoes ionization. Here I am taking an auto ionization reaction. Two molecules of H2O. So what molecule is undergoing ionization such that other will take H plus ion, which is converted into H3O plus and OH minus. Once equilibrium is established, we can write equilibrium expression. So here water is present a very high volume. So I am taking as a constant, because auto ionization, the dissociation of water is very less. So the bulk quantity we are taking as a constant. As the product of two constant, we get a ionic product of water or ionic product constant, which is a product of H plus and OH minus. This value at 25 degrees, it is a constant equal to 1 into 10 power minus 14 mole square by liter square, or dm6. And at equilibrium, H plus and OH minus concentration is equal for pure water. So if both the product is equal to 10 power minus 14, H plus and OH minus concentration must be equal to 10 power minus 7. It is moles per liter or molar. The important of Kw is it is constant. No matter what and all substance we are dissolving in water, the ionic product of water is constant at particular temperature. It is equal to 10 power minus 14. But we are adding a different substances, the resulting solution may be changes, acidic, basic, neutral, but the Kw value remain constant. So the important note that meaning of Kw is a constant at particular temperature. No matter whatever the substance we are adding, the product of H plus and OH minus concentration must be equal, that is equal to 10 power minus 14. So based on this, we can derive three situations. If the substance is neutral, then H plus and OH minus concentration must be equal. If the substance is acidic, means H plus concentration is increasing, H plus concentration is increasing, then OH minus decreases, which is less than that of H plus concentration, the resulting solution we call it as acidic solution. If OH minus is higher concentration than H plus, that is basic solution, where in the basic solution OH minus ion concentration is higher than H plus concentration, the resultant solution we call it as basic solution. So depends upon the concentration of H plus, we can assign whether this is basic solution or neutral solution or acidic solution. If both are equal, we call it as neutral, or H plus is higher, we call it as acidic solution. If OH minus is high, we call it as basic solution. How we have to assign or how we have to understand the strength of acid or base? So we need another parameter that is called pH scale. Let's move on to pH scale. From ionic product of water, the aqueous solution contains both the ion H plus ion, OH minus ion, whether the solution is acidic or alkaline or neutral. If it is an acidic solution, where the difference will be there, H plus concentration is higher than OH minus concentration. If it is an alkaline, that is basic solution, OH minus concentration is high compared with H plus. Neutral condition or neutral case, H plus is equal to OH minus. So whatever the solution you take, both is having H plus ion concentration and OH minus concentration, but relative strength will be different. So the product of this concentration always constant. Now how we have to assign strength of the acids and bases? By taking pH scale. It is very convenient to express acidity or basicity of a solution by referring the H plus concentration. If we know one, we can tell that whether the solution is acidic or basic. Sorensen introduced a convenient scale for indicating H plus ion concentration, which called pH scale. What is pH scale? It is defined as the pH of a solution is the negative logarithm. The logarithm is here base 10. The negative logarithm of the concentration of hydrogen ion which it contains, that we call it as pH. pH is the negative logarithm of the H plus ion is equal to pH, which has given by mathematical expression Sorensen. By taking this, we can explain the strength of the solution, whether it is acidic or neutral or basic. Let's take example. In the previous slide, we have discussed that the pure water H plus ion concentration is equal to 10 power minus 7. When I apply here pH scale, pH equal to minus log of H plus concentration. What is the concentration here? 10 power minus 7. And its concentration is represented moles per liter. Now when we calculate here pH, I can take 7 here, minus into minus, plus log 10 is equal to 1. So pH value is equal to 7 for pure water at 25 degrees. And pure water is having both H plus concentration and OH minus concentration is equal. And this is called neutral point, pH 7. Here it is pH 7, it is neutral, and below the pH 7 the value is less than 7 pH, that we call it as acidic solution. If it is above, we call it as base solution. So the pH scale usually present between 0 to 14, and mid is water where H plus and OH minus concentration is equal, and when it is comes to the down 7 to 0, H plus concentration is high compared with the OH minus concentration. And here OH minus concentration is high compared with H plus concentration. So by taking H plus concentration, we can assign strength or nature of the solution. It is pure water here, pH is 7. When it comes to concentrated HCl, 1 molar, approximately it is 0. When it comes to 1 molar sodium hydroxide, it is equal to 14. So whatever the laboratory ammonia we are using, the pH will be there, basic nature is around 12. Acetic acid approximately it is at 3. So pH scale will be present between 0 to 14 and 7 is mid-pad, which is having H plus and OH minus is equal. It is called a neutral solution, and above the pH value we call it as basic and below we call it as acidic solution. So by taking pH scale we can assign the resulting solution either acidic or basic or neutral solution. If we know the concentration we can calculate pH and we can tell that the resulting solution is acidic or basic. Let's take first example. Calculate the pH of 0.001 molar HCl solution. Then what is the pH and the nature of the solution, whether it is acidic or basic or neutral. pH equal to minus log H plus, and here they have given a concentration. HCl concentration, HCl is dissociated as a H plus and Cl minus. It is a strong electrolyte, dissociation will be 100%. And initially what is the concentration? 0.001. How much ion, H plus ion concentration? It is a strong electrolyte which gives 0.001 molar of H plus. Now we know the H plus concentration here, then we can calculate pH and we can tell that the resulting solution is whether it is acidic, basic or neutral. By taking this pH equal to minus log of 0.001, I can write 10 power minus 4. Now if you calculate this, 4 into log 10, pH value is 4 and it is below 7, the resulting solution is acidic solution. Let's take another example. Determine the pH of 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution and tell me what is the nature of solution, whether it is acidic or basic or neutral. So here they have given a sodium hydroxide which is a strong base which ionizes 100% into Na plus and OH minus. What is the concentration? 0.10, which produces 0.10 of Na plus, 0.10 of OH minus ion. So here they have given a OH minus ion concentration, but we have to find out H plus concentration to calculate pH. How we can get H plus ion concentration? By taking OH minus. We have ionic product of water formula, Kw equal to concentration of H plus and concentration of OH minus. Kw is constant and OH minus they have given. We can calculate H plus concentration equal to Kw by OH minus. What is the Kw value? 10 power minus 14 by what is the OH minus concentration? It is a 0.1. 0.1 I can write it as a 10 power minus 1. I can take it up, it become plus 1, minus 14 plus 1, it will give 10 power minus 13 molar solution of H plus. Now I got a H plus ion concentration. If I know the H plus ion concentration, I calculate pH. pH equal to minus log of H plus concentration. Now what is the H plus value here? 10 power minus 13. pH equal to minus log of 10 power minus 13, which gives pH equal to 13, and the pH value is 13, which is above 7, then this resulting solution is basic solution. If we know the H plus ion concentration, we can calculate both the cases, acids and bases. Even if we know the pH value, we can calculate H plus ion concentration. Let's see another example. If a solution is having a pH of 7.41, determine its H plus ion concentration. So in this problem they have given pH value. And they are asking a concentration of H plus ion. How we can determine? pH equal minus log of H plus concentration. Now they are asking a concentration of H plus. Now how I can write H plus, and it is a logarithm base 10. I can write 10 power, because if I take it in this fashion, log of H plus, if I take minus other side, minus pH. Now when I convert H plus, 10 power minus 10 power minus pH. Now they have given a pH value. If I substitute here, I can get the concentration of H plus. So H plus equal 10 power minus 7.41. This is approximately equal to 3.9 into 10 power minus 8 molar of H plus. So in this slide I have given a solution. It is a 10 power minus 7.41. It is equal to 3.9 into 10 power minus 8 molar. Let's move on to another problem. So this problem you can solve. The hydrogen ion concentration of a fruit juice is 3.3 into 10 power minus 2. 10 power minus 2 molar. What is the pH of the juice? And whether it is acidic or basic? So they have given a concentration of H plus ion is equal to 3.3 into 10 power minus 2 molar. Now you have to calculate pH of the juice, and finally based on the pH value you have to tell that whether the juice is acidic in nature or basic in nature. I would like to move on to other topic, that is common ion effect. What is common ion effect? The reduction or suppression of the degree of dissociation of a electrolyte by the addition of another electrolyte of higher strength having common ion is known as common ion effect. So the degree of dissociation of generally a weak electrolyte by addition of another electrolyte, usually strong electrolyte, which is having a common ion, is known as common ion effect. Let's take a general, an electrolyte, let's assume AB, which is a weak electrolyte, which is dissociated into in this fashion, A plus and B minus. It is not 100% because the electrolyte is weak. Now to this electrolyte solution, I am adding another electrolyte, AOH. And AOH also dissociated in this fashion. And here AOH is, let's assume it is strong electrolyte, which is dissociated into in this fashion. So what happened here? Now we have added a AOH which is dissociated, and both is having a one common ion, A plus. Now when I apply here equilibrium constant K equal to concentration of A plus and B minus by AB. When we are adding AOH, which concentration is increasing? A plus concentration is increasing because both is having common ion. Now to maintain K is constant, what happened? Numerator is increasing. To maintain a K constant, obviously denominator should increases. Now if it is AB is increasing, the equilibrium is shifted towards in this direction, and this is we call it as reduction or suppression of degree of dissociation of electrolyte. It is a weak electrolyte, it is dissociating. Due to this common ion, the dissociation is decreasing or suppression, and this we call it as common ion effect. We are observing there is a one common ion should be present, then only the degree of dissociation further depressed of weak electrolyte, and this effect is called common ion effect. Let's take one example. Addition of NH4Cl to ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide is a weak electrolyte, NH4OH, which dissociated into in this fashion NH4 plus OH minus. Now for this we are adding another electrolyte, NH4Cl. I am writing here equilibrium constant for this NH4OH, OH minus. Now we are adding ammonium chloride, which is a strong electrolyte, which is dissociated into in this fashion NH4 plus Cl minus. What happened once we are adding, already NH4 plus ion present here, and when we are adding NH4 Cl, which is also giving NH4 plus, overall NH4 plus concentration is increasing. To maintain K, what happened? NH4OH concentration should increase. How it will increase? It will combine NH4 plus and OH minus, and which gives a backward reaction. So the equilibrium is shifted toward the left hand side. It is a weak electrolyte, which is dissociation is not 100%, but after addition of NH4Cl, the degree of dissociation of this weak electrolyte further suppressed, means it is reduced, and this effect is called common ion effect. In presence of one ion should be common, that's why we call it as it is a common ion effect. In conclusion, in today's class you have learned ionic product of water, pH scale, pH formula, and pH of the solution, and lastly we have discussed about common ion effect. With this topic we have completed ionic equilibria 1. Next class I am going to start ionic equilibria 2.